Hey guys, it's Haff. I am back again. I have all the rest of my makeup on, but no eyeshadow on. One of my viewers asked me to do a particular eye look that I was wearing. I can't remember exactly what I did, but what I'm going to do is how I basically do my eyeshadow for my particular eye type, the way I like to do it. I have fairly hooded eyes, like when you go like this, you can't see any eyelid. That's what a hooded eye is. So I haven't done anything to my eyes, so I'm just going to go through what my basic process is when I'm doing my eye makeup. Pretty much do it the same way, I just use different colours depending on the day. So I'm starting with an eye primer. This happens to be the LA Girl HD in skin colour. So I'm just going to whack some of that on. Blend it in. That's makeup on the back of my hand, in case you're wondering. I didn't bother cleaning off my hand. I actually had to redo all my base makeup, which just put me behind where I was going to be today, because it was terrible. I tried a different foundation and it looked terrible. Now I'm just going to take my Lorac Pro, Mega Pro, and I'm using Opal, which is this one here, just to set the primer. The main reason we set primer is just so that things glide a bit. Like, you put the primer on to make eyeshadow last longer, and you set the primer so that you can blend over the top of it more easily, because sometimes primers are a bit grippy, which you want, because you want your eyeshadow to stick, but, yeah. And usually you set it with a colour that's fairly close to your own skin tone. It's like preparing a canvas. It's basically what you're doing is preparing your canvas. So, next, I take a transition colour. At the moment I'm using this one. This is a pigment, like loose eyeshadow. It's called Obscure. So you want something that's darker than your skin colour, but not by much. This one is one that if you put it on really lightly, it's not too dark. You've got to make sure you tap off all the excess. So basically what I do is I put my head back slightly and I hit, you can see the crease line is here. Let me zoom in a little bit. So you can see where my lid is. It's basically right above that. So I stick my brush like that. So it's just above where that crease line is. And then blend that in. I'm sorry if you can hear all the noise, like television and stuff in the background, but you know, this is a household with lots and lots of people in it, and it's Sunday, and yeah. So basically, just do that and blend it in, and then do the same thing on the other side. So just above where the crease line is. It helps to tip your head backwards so you can see it properly when you have hooded eyes. Now your transition colour is there to kind of, you know, like if you're doing a painting, you do an underpainting, which gives sort of a thing that adds continuity between all of the colours. That is kind of what transition shades are. A bit like an underpainting. And you can build that up as much as you want to, depending on what kind of eye look you're doing. So if you're going for like a really dramatic one, you build it up more. And you want to make sure you blend out the edge that's up the top there. And you can see, you can barely see that when I put my head down. You can just see it on the edges there. That is what happens with hooded eyes. So you can bring the shadow up a bit higher when you've got hooded eyes, so you don't have this massive area of nothing. But I personally don't mind the massive area of nothing. But I am actually going to bring this up a bit higher today. So this is pretty much what I do every time I do my eyeshadow. At the moment, this is pretty much the only transition colour I use. So I'm trying to use up. I am actually panning this one. And then we have... I am going to go into... because I am doing a purple eye. I am actually going to go straight to the lid, which I don't always do, but I am today. And I'm taking this one here, which is one that I'm currently trying to hit tan in. And I'm just going to pack that on the mobile lid. The mobile lid is the bit that moves around. So if you hear your favourite beauty guru talking about, I'm putting on my mobile lid, they're talking about the part of the lid that moves. Now this shadow is not very pigmented, so I actually have to put on quite a bit. I could probably wet it, and you know, of course if you want more power pack, you could use a white primer, that will help, or wet the brush using something like Max Fix Plus or any makeup setting spray or even saline, do the same thing. And I'm going to go back to the brush that I put my transition in, and I'm just going to blend between the two of them, like through the crease line. Just going to blend through there. Just to blend. See, on this side, it's not blended on this side. It's got the blend so it doesn't have like that harsh line. I mean, a cut crease is where you keep your harsh line, and a blend is where you get rid of the harsh line. So that's that bit. And then the next thing I do is go into a darker colour. Now it depends on what I'm using. For this one I'm going to use a dark purple, but you could use a brown, a black, anything you want. With black, do be careful, depending on how pigmented it is. I'm actually going to use this purple down here that I've already hit tan in. And with this, I'm going to go right into where the crease is there. Put it in there and sort of like follow my eyeball and then go in kind of a V. So follow the eyeball and then sort of like along the lash line, so it's in a V shape. And then do the same thing on the other eye. Now I'm going to build this up, because I like to. But that's basically what I'm just going to do. So just put it on first. Oopsie. That went where I didn't want it to go. Okay, well, that'll change things slightly. I've just put some on the other side in the same location. And then take the blending brush again and blend that in. Now, depending on what kind of shadows you're using, you might have to go back and go over it again, blend, go over it again. again. So I'm just going to do that until I am happy with how it looks. Might need to go back into your lid colour and re-put that on a bit more. It sometimes blends away. I'm going to take my little brush, go back into the really dark purple, and go under the eye. And you want to join that up to the darkness that you put in your outer corner. And take your blending brush and just blend it a little with whatever's on your brush, just to blend it out a bit so it's not quite so harsh. And that is pretty much how I do my eyeshadow. I just use different colours. So I am going to finish this up and then I will be back. So that is the finished look, guys. All I did was add some mascara, turtle tees, which I think is nearly ready to go. It's starting to be really clumpy. My usual clump crusher on the bottom. I put on some black eyeliner and then put my NYX Vivid Brights in, what do they call this, Vivid Violet over the top, blue, slightly purple, and lined my waterline with some dark brown pencil. So that is it. That's how I basically do my eyeshadow, just with different colours normally. So yeah, if you want to subscribe, click the button down there, leave me a thumbs up. If you like makeup type videos, click the bell if you want to get notified of when I upload new content. And leave me a comment down below. I try to respond to all comments, and I'll see you in my next video. See ya!